Security fencing becomes number eight. Security fencing must be installed around the electrical equipment related to commercial solar. And appropriate warning signs must be posted at safe intervals, the entrance and around the perimeter of the commercial. We don't have anything there that talks about, it just says. There's no designated footage, I guess, of how often, just safe intervals. So I'll put something specific there and just leave it as this.
I think they already have, I mean, they built it like a substation where there's already a requirement for.
And I think the word appropriate warning signs, I think it says sings there. See that word right there?
Oh, it does.
It's spelled wrong.
G in the N.
Number nine becomes number eight.
I got one question.
Oh, I'm sorry, yeah.
On the wind, we had to put down on the warning signs who to call if something went wrong.
Yeah.
Remember how we did that? Do we want to add that to that?
Yeah, I think we could.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Or just a number or whatever to, I mean, may not check out, but at least. That's the one I would.
So then we actually.
So has emergency contact number on?
Yeah. Including.
Including site address and site number. I think that's probably pull that right from the part two.
Including emergency contact. With the number?
Yeah.
Anything else there? Good call. Noise becomes number nine. The noise generated must not exceed any of the following limits. I have 40 dBA LMAX.
Property line.
At the property line, yes.
At the property line, yeah. I think.
Yes, property line, I'm sorry.
We've got a lot of line in the adjacent R1. We just put at the property line, we could get rid of specific. We're not changing.
We don't need to have D.
Yeah, I don't think, if we're not going to specifically list every type of adjacent lot, we're just going to say at any lot line has got to be of not participating.
Do we want that other sentence in there that we have in the wind when it talks about? Talks about the township may, in its sole discretion, allow a lease or setback if the owner of a non-trespassing property signs a waiver. Do you want that in there?
Yes.
Yeah.
Talk about the lesser setbacks.
Yep.
Waivers recorded by the county register of deeds.
Mm-hmm. I think that would be
appropriate.
Mm-hmm.
I come over with Jenny.
Where are you going to put that one at?
We're going to put that at the end.
Well, we could put it all the way back up in setbacks.
You'd have to do it for both sound and for setback.
Yeah, we just have to word it different. Put it for setbacks, which we have at 500 feet. I don't know if they'd ever go closer, but we could put it in there in case they wanted to. And then it requires them to get permission from the adjacent landowner. And same for the decibel rating, same wording, but put it for, not for setbacks, but for.
So that's 2C is what where we're at that, Jane.
Okay, the one that you crossed off, that you changed to C.
We crossed off C, but then we changed D to C.
Okay, so now you're going to change.
We're going to add. We're going to add to that a sentence that says, the township may, in its sole discretion, allow a lesser setback. Only if the owner of a non-trespassing property signs a waiver consenting to the lesser setback, and that the waiver is recorded by the county register of deeds, but in no case shall the setback be less than. other section, we have 500 feet when it comes to a setback of public roads, lot lines.
And you wouldn't want to go any closer to it than 100 just for the fence that would be and anything else. That would be like your drop dead distance.
So I'm hearing 100. So be setback be no less than 100 feet. Any discussion there on that number? Hearing none. Want to read that one more time to you, Jenny, or no?
No, I'm good.
Okay. Kind of said it loud, so you hear.
I know you did. You said it fast.
I did?
No.
I'm going to say it again. So we're back to bullet point number 9, which was 8. Noise. The noise generated by the commercial energy system must not exceed 40 dBA LMAX as measured at the property line.
Can we not have all of those subparts and just put it in that sentence?
Yep, I think B, C, and D are going to go bye-bye.
I think we'd get rid of A just by putting noise. The noise generated by a commercial solar energy system must not exceed 40 dBA LMAX.
Yep.
It's done.
And then we're going to put the waiver back in there.
Yeah.
Right?
So are we keeping D or not?
I was reading D.
Yeah.
I think we can talk about D, yes.
I think we could put berms in as number 9, maybe. I'm just trying to read what the
in addition about limitations, the sound barrier of a solid
evergreen tree berm.
May stir the wall.
Dirt berm, it says a tree berm. We got very specific on how tall.
It says that it doesn't problem that on the other nothing. You know, I mean, every year to.
I guess we could have a part that says the use of natural or earth berms to reduce that noise level will be permitted at the township's discretion. Because if they're going to build it too close, and then this guy, oh, we're going to be over 40, but if we build this little, if we build this masonry wall, it'll reduce that. They'd have to get our approval, but it would allow for them.
Okay, this let's just back up a little bit. Noise becomes 9, was 8, correct? The noise generated by the commercial solar system must not exceed 40 dBA LMAX as measured at the property line. Period.
Yep.
And then we need to have the sentence of
waiver options.
We can say the use of berms, natural or masonry, are permitted to have how do we say it?
I think we need to add in there though the township may in its sole discretion allow a lesser if the owner of a non-participating property line signs a waiver. Right?
Mm-hmm.
For that same sentence. Everybody good with that or no?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Because obviously they can record that at the county and register the deeds, just like we've done with the wind.
That's what we should be, that we were talking about berms, so we put berms as number 10, berms, and then set it all down separate from.
Yeah. So that's noise, and then B goes away, C goes away, D becomes number 10. Am I hearing you right?
And then we'll word it a little bit different.
Yep, I'm going to go. I want to hear that thought.
I'm going to say, the use of berms to comply with the use of berms to comply with
sound
will be permitted at the township's discretion. There, that would work. Because then they would approach us whether or not, because I mean, to tell them that they could build 10 feet apart with trees, I mean, do we really want to dictate down to what they're, I mean, they're gonna approach us and say, this is what we're thinking.
Yep, it should be respectful. How you coming, Jenny?
I'm good. So you made that number 10, so we're taking away, like, we're gonna underground.
B, C, and D are gone.
These, right, so then that will make 9, number 11.
Yes, we're not there yet, but yep.
Okay.
But D will now become the berm.
Right.
Okay. So 9, to Jenny's point, number 9 now becomes 11.
Correct.
Talks about underground transmission. Everybody all set with that?
We had a requirement, we had a requirement under the wind that should look the same under solar, but I don't, they don't transmit.
As much?
They don't produce an energy enough to make it transmission voltage that they would be burying for miles to go somewhere. Every one of these is plugged right into a three-phase distribution line outside of it. But I think we should still say 10 feet, which would match what we have on our wind ordinance. So if they do and want.
At a depth of 10 feet.
At a depth of 10 feet.
Cross all the others.
So at a depth of 10 feet, and then we're gonna eliminate that complies with the current National Electric Code standards. Except power switch yards or within a substation.
Correct.
So all that goes away. Want to repeat that? That complies with the current National Electric Code except for the power switch yards or area within the substation that goes eliminated.
Just change it to 10 feet.
You want to put located underground at a depth of 10 feet?
Yes. Period. Doing good, guys.
Okay, got it.
I agree with the last sentence.
I think so too. Everybody okay with that?
Get rid of the last sentence if that is.
No, leave it.
I'll leave it, okay.
If batteries are used, ground mounted, must be in a secure, yeah, container enclosed. Number 10 becomes number 12. Drain tunnel inspections. Any add to that, Dave?
I mean, I like this, so the applicant and operator must inspect all drain tiles at least once every 3 years by the means, the first occurring before is an operation. But I think there should be one after it's put in to make sure if they crushed anything, it's fixed before. Otherwise, they're not required for 3 years after, that's how I read it, right?
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
We could just say, just add in the applicant must, or what does it say? With the first inspection occurring before the commercial solar energy system and after it is in operation.
Yes.
Immediately upon completion. There you go.
Must occur any damage from 60 days after discovery.
60 days?
60 days is a long time.
Is it?
Yes. Because, I mean, especially if it's coming off a neighboring property, goes through there. Yeah, I mean, that could be flooded out.
That's a problem that needs to be.
Now.
Fixed now. 60 days is too long.
What would be a good amount?
30 too long?
Today.
The day it's finished.
I would say within 7 days or less, I mean, that's.
When you're farming, yeah.
And that's when they find it, that.
Yeah, it could have been long before that, that's where.
And can we put any wording in there that if there's evidence of a backup, then that, once every 3 years, they have to go check to see?
Yeah.
So if there's evidence of a backup that requires an inspection immediately?
And then they have 7 days.
Or within 7 days.
Well, no, immediately inspect, and then they have 7 days to fix it once they find it, because, yeah, I think that would be. They have the address, okay, so we can put it.
Who's in charge of paying for those inspections?
Oh, they would be.
You might want to put that in there.
I
commercial energy is not the landowner.
I think we have some, and that's, it's under ordinance, that's the cost of business.
The owner or operator must repair any damage or failure of the drain tile, so the cost, that right there says that there.
Dot your i's, cross your t's.
Say again.
It said dot your i's and cross your t's, put it in there.
I'll just write some word we could, the owner or operator must.
The owner operator must repair at their cost.
Well, cause we're also talking the inspection, so I'm thinking, so the applicant or operator must inspect all drain tiles at least once every 3 years or upon any evidence of damage. So we could add that into that sentence by means of robotic camera. The first inspecting occurring before the commercial solar energy system is in operation and immediately upon completion. All costs of inspections will be at the owner slash operator's expense.
Inspection and repair?
Yeah.
Bill, can I say something?
Yeah.
That's all good, but who's gonna tell them about that? You know, Joe's got cornfield that's flooding out. Don't you wanna put something else in there? Cause if Joe's the neighboring property, they inspected it and they say, well, that's too bad, Joe. We already inspected it.
We're good.
We're good. I think you wanna put something in there about neighboring property or complaints of.
That's what I was looking for, the complaint.
And the township then checks it out, but that's it.
Okay, so number 12, drain tile inspections. You wanna go with this, Quan or Dave?
Quan had it written down.
I didn't have it written down yet, I was going off the cusp of it.
The commercial energy system must be maintained in working condition at all times while in operation. The applicant or operator must inspect all drain tiles at least once every 3 years or evidence of.
Or immediately if evidence of damage is found. Found or reported.
Reported, yeah.
There you go.
So say that again. Once every 3 years or immediately.
If any damage is evident or reported. By means of robotic camera. With the first inspection occurring before the commercial solar energy system is in operation and immediately following completion.
Are you guys just talking about?
The next sentence would be, all inspections and repairs will be at the cost of the owner slash operator.
I think this is saying, for onsite. Or did you find anything else on neighboring?
No.
So that probably should be a part of this section.
As far as
the owner operator being liable for.
Anything existing?
Well, I guess if they have a set spot of property and it goes and there's a drain tile that goes through it and there's a problem upstream here, but the problem ends up being here, that would not be really their fault or problem. Because if it occurs inside their scope, that would be on them and that's what this would be dictating.
Yeah, it's an on-site problem, but what if they say they inspected it and Joe's field is not draining because they did not inspect it?
Right, that's why we put that in. Or immediately if evidence is apparent or reported.
By neighboring also.
By anybody.
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't know, but I'm just.
Yeah, I would think that they would be, I mean, what if it's a public land next to it and somebody drives by and it's like, this road's not normally flooded. But I think specifically listed who could or property owner, just as long as it's any evidence of or reports of would require them to have to inspect.
Okay. that, Jenny?
Yeah, I'll go back and look for that.
I got you, Jenny. I got you.
Let me try to fumble through this. The commercial energy system must be maintained in working condition all times while in operation. The county operator must inspect all drain tile at least once every 3 years or immediately. Or to 3 years, or immediately when evidence or reported
evidence of damage,
okay.
Breach of the system.
By means of robotic camera, with the first inspection occurring before the commercial energy system is in operation and immediately following completion. Is that kind of right?
Can we, I guess I missed it, but the commercial solar energy system is in operation. No, the commercial solar energy system, before the commercial energy solar system is constructed and then immediately following completion. Okay. So basically that'd be like, after they get their site plan filled out, that'll be like the first inspection before they ever put a shovel on the ground.
The applicant has an official inspection of the township. The owner must repair any damage or failure drain tile within. Is 7 days even feasible?
Is it possible to get somebody to do something that quick?
Dave?
Just takes an excavator and his pipe. You gotta dig a hole, so you have 3 days for a miss dig. So.
Yeah.
It is.
We got to put a number there, though. I mean, if we're.
If we give them too much time and it's a big problem, they're gonna milk it. But if it's a big problem, it needs to get taken care of. And there's no reason why. I mean, even if you make a phone call and call a miss dig, in 3 days you can have equipment on site digging a hole.
And so the emergency call.
Yeah, and if it's an emergency, you get in 3 hours.
So we'll put 7 days?
Yeah. When you guys wouldn't wait outside your house for a broken pole for 7 days.
A couple hours.
No,
3 minutes.
If their basement's flooded now, they're gonna wait 7 days
before they have a
water line shut off, or they don't want to shut off now.
Okay. So we're good there?
I am.
Mm-hmm. Insurance? Good. 11 becomes 13. Decommissioning becomes number 14. Talk about 6 months of abandoned. Or if it's halted a period of a year.
Is there someplace in there that says we paid for that decommissioning? Is there somewhere in here?
Yes.
Sorry, being halted.
Yeah. That was a question back in A on the very beginning.
Mm-hmm. We went over this with Windmill saying, I think, did we say it here? Did we say? So this one says, solar energy system is abandoned, has not been in operation for a period of 1 year. This includes solar energy. Never operational if construction has been halted for a period of 1 year. Here's a long time, but all at the same time, it's not a long time.
Mm-hmm.
1 year of the property was not in construction within 6 months, so.
I think, guys.
I mean, I think after a year gives them time to either sell it and keep it operational or determine and then come up, because they know that as soon as it's considered a year, they have 6 months, so they'll have to have plans to get it out of there.
Number 13 becomes number 15, and it talks about the decommissioning and who's financial, having the funds and escrow. And then
and the operator in the township will review, obviously, the financial security every 2 years. And it must be posted within 15 days after the approval of a special land use application. Which is good, right? This is here, 24 hours, number 14 becomes number 16. And they have 24 hours to let the township know of any failures, fire, leakages, hazard, injuries. Good with that? 17 becomes 15, 15 becomes 17. Talks about proof of insurance, liability, or summary of all complaints and complaint resolutions. Reported before January 1st of each year. I would say approved, but I think the new township in there, we don't want to do it. It's just common sense. Inspections. Township can inspect 24 hour notice. So 16 becomes 18. 17 becomes 19. That comes a transfer with the township. When he talks about remedies. You go with that? That completes section two. Section 3, we need to kind of change that, right?
Yeah. Oh, hold on. Section of zoning is A1. So the first one is fine, groundwater, private solar. Or we could put just private solar energy systems and then strike out the commercial solar energy systems.
Everybody go with that? Section 4. Repealer, section 5. All done. Now I think what we should do with this is we should probably get it typed up for like our general meeting and review.
Yeah.
Right thing to do.
I think so too. I think it needs to be reviewed before that January meeting.
Yeah. Well, yeah, no, we won't have a public hearing or nothing on this. We need to go through it again.
I think it would be nice to have it all typed up and then we'll submit it at the January if we agree,
we'll move on to the public hearing. There's a lot of stuff there.
Bill?
Yeah.
Would you want, and this David kind of probably knows about a little bit, would you want anything in there about being told when they're decommissioned stuff? Because I don't know if anybody's known that the Met Tower got decommissioned and nobody said anything to the township or anybody. So would you want that in there? If they decommission, the township should be aware of that project going on.
Ours here says that they have to go and get a demolition permit to remove it.
Mm-hmm. Okay, well, because the Met Tower was taken down and nobody knew about it.
I don't think they do that, right?
They just applied for
it. Even with the new wind ordinance, I think we say they have to get a building permit or a demolition permit.
It's gone.
Good, but we could have got some more money, though.
I know there's questions out there about the permit that they have. tap because it was.
It's not done correctly.
They took it down?
Mm-hmm, I didn't know that, it stuck when I go to work.
They must be taking all of them down, so taking one down and double it.
So.
Can I ask one question about legal fees? Is it covered by the energy company, like any legal fees that come upon the township for the, this? Are they covered by them?
Remedies, if an applicant or fails to comply with the ordinance, township in addition to any other remedy under this ordinance may revoke special land use, blah, blah, blah. Additionally, the township may pursue any legal or equitable action to abate a violation to recover any and all costs, including the township's actual attorney fees and costs.
Okay. Perfect.
So that concludes our old business, no new business, public comments. Open public comments, yes.
I wanna say thank you guys for, one, letting us interact, because that's really beneficial and has, it means a lot to us, so. Thank you all for all the hard work that you've done. I really, really appreciate it. I know the township appreciates it also.
Is this about anything? Can you make a comment?
Yep.
I've got something I wrote here about what happened a couple of months ago at one of your meetings when you turned down the land splits, voted on it and turned it down. May I read that?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. Well, Mr. Burnwell, he made quite a few comments on, against it, so. In 1968, Don and Catherine Edgar gave John and Diane Briggs, daughter and son-in-law, 1 acre of land to build a house on. They built a house and barn there and lived at that location until 1989, when Don and Catherine passed John and Diane moved up to their farm. It was 80-acre parcel, and when they split it, it was supposed to be 79 acres and 1 acre. We saw on different things that it showed 80 acres and 1 acre. The assessor said it wasn't like that, though. We went to a board of review meeting and asked about it. We didn't ask why we didn't, somebody asked us why we just didn't add that acre back in so it could be homesteaded. Paul Main was asked if he didn't have places they'd done this with. Paul said yes.